Cristóvão Buarque, senator in the Brazilian Senate, former minister of education, wrote a beautiful short book called The Gold Curtain. And he described, speaking of ethics and business, the gold curtain that fell after the Iron Curtain ceased to exist. The gold curtain protects 1.5 billion consumers. As for the rest, they are either the aspiring bourgeoisie, Brazil, India, Japan, would love to become members of the Security Council. And as I say to them every time we speak, if and when you become members of the Security Council, remember how secure the Security Council makes us all feel. What are you going to do to correct the course? The term human security was coined to shift the focus of security from the state to the individual, to emphasize freedom from fear and want. And I say this to our master of ceremonies because I assume that she belongs to the Chicago school of Milton Friedman. Because of her comments on a video clip that I sent her before this meeting on the work of the Integrity Council, which I have the privilege of presiding, of the call for global commons, for a referendum on global commons. And I want to say to you that these global commons, for which we are calling, and the we includes people like Martti Ahtisaari, Mary Robinson, all those NGOs with which I've worked, 125 Jewish and Arab NGOs. You see, I'm terribly confused and confusing. I talk to Jews who barely talk to each other. I talk to Arabs who can't stand each other. I talk to Arabs who speak to Jews. And therefore, I am neither with you nor against you. But the global commons of which I speak start with the inherently spiritual, ontological, and simultaneous in world time. And therefore, please, Milton Friedman, give us a break. We need to promote efficiency and sustainability in a global and open society. In plain language, when President Kohler goes to Rwanda with green helmets, Jews, Christians and Muslims, to build a clinic and a school, I say well done. Because it is the seed, the kernel of a multidimensional, multinational, international peace corps. Young people thinking and acting globally and locally, revealing their sovereignty as world citizens. The sovereignty, as you both said, that starts within. The internet, not the internet. Are we free citizens or are we kept citizens? I broke my tooth, I'm going to the dentist after this session, grinding it as I went through the immigration controls in New York Airport. They were very polite to me, thank goodness. So I didn't have to swim back. But I think global commons can only thrive on transparent communication and networking. And this is why my first invitation to you all, and I will make the information available to you during the course of your sessions, is that the trialogue considers a dotted line relationship with our appeal for a coalition for global commons between now and 2010. MECCA, Middle East Citizens Assembly, includes Israelis, Iranians, Turks, Saudi Arabians, Jordanians, Egyptians, etc. Everybody is in the pot. Even Syrians. You know, of course, that we exist at the intersection of society and nature. We cannot manage 80 miles radius of conflict without a holistic view of the management of water resources. I was speaking to Yossi Beilin the other day, and I hope I'm not betraying a trust, but I said to him, what use is the Red Dead Canal or the Red Dead Pipeline if it is going, according to the International Union for the Conservation of Nature, to Professor Watzmann from Israel, to Yehuda Elkana, the rector of the Central European University, and others, if it is going to produce oxygen chloride, which from school days I remember stinks. Stink bombs? We've got all the other kind of bombs in the making or stored away somewhere. So why not a stink bomb? In the Dead Sea, to make it truly dead for tourism. The only answer that is logical to my mind of making the desert bloom is to stop triumphalist agriculture within a supranational context and develop drought-resistant agriculture which provides sweet water for the dying sea. Within a vision of a carrying capacity for the region, for 20 years I have said that Palestinians living in this country are citizens with full rights and responsibilities. This is not a revelation. I say my father was born in Mecca, your father was born in Nablus, that doesn't make you any less of a Jordanian if that's what you wish to be. But the point is basically that are we directing our projects at promoting human dignity? There's been a lot of talk here from the platform about Israeli-Jordanian. This is not about Israeli-Jordanian, it's about Abrahamic and eliminating world poverty. So before I get accused yet again of being a normalizer, which is a sort of contradiction in terms, an oxymoron. Who would not wish to have normal relations with his neighbor? But given the realities on the ground, the stasis in Gaza and the West Bank, I don't want to get into politics, I can understand where that criticism comes from. At least I can comprehend.